Spice cake? A Bud Light? Oh, man. Go Wisconsin. That was a commercial for the Crocker Bank. Now, after Close to You, Richard was looking for his next big hit. He heard the commercial, and he recognized the voice as Paul Williams. Well, as luck would have it, they both worked for A&M Records. So one day he approached him on the lot and asked him if he had anything more than the two verses and the one chorus that he heard in the commercial. Well, Paul said yes, but it was really a no. So he went ahead and wrote the song really quickly, and he gave it to Richard, who, of course, made complete magic with it. It became probably the most popular requested first dance wedding song of all time. Anybody out here use it? You did? You're still together. That's a good thing. Congratulations. How many years? Aww. Congratulations, that's wonderful. You have other people out here that used it? Well, that's another good reason to use it. It also was very popular for graduations. Well, we're glad that Richard took a chance on this song because it became the Carpenters' signature hit. My daughter and my son-in-law, and yes, they're still married. is a good thing because wedding was really expensive. But after 7 years, the best thing of all happened to us last year, and I became a grandma. And that's my little Macy Violet. Oh, and she's delicious and awesome. And yes, she's going to be a big sister in February. We're going to have another little girl. All you grandparents, you were right. It is the best thing. It really is, and I can't wait. I can't wait to get back to her. Yeah, give yourselves a round of applause, grandparents. What did they say? If I had known how great it would have been, I would have done that first. Doesn't work that way. All right. Normally, when I do this song, I say, let's pretend it's snowing. We're not going to do that. Because you brought the snow, you Wisconsins or Wisconsians, or what do they call you? Wisconsinites? I'm not going. I'm not starting with the sports. Okay, everybody here from Wisconsin, you brought the snow, thank you. So, because we need the snow for this next song, okay? That's all I'm saying. Just hear the sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Let's take the road before us and sing a chorus or two. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, let's go. Let's look at the show. We're riding in a wonderland of snow.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, that's grand. Just holding your hand.
Let's sing the road before us and sing a chorus or two.
Come on, it's lovely when the horse can ride together with you.
There's a Christmas party at the home of Farmer Gray. It'll be the perfect ending of a perfect day. We'll be singing the songs we love to sing without a single stop.
At the fireplace while we watch the chestnuts pop. Pop, pop, pop.
There's a happy feeling nothing in the world can buy. As we pass around the coffee and the pumpkin pie. It'll really be like a picture print by Carrier and Dice.
These wonderful things are things we remember all through our lives.
Come on, it's lovely when the course they ride together with you. Let's sing the road before us and sing another chorus or two.
Tour in Canada, the Carpenters had been working tirelessly, so their manager said, you know what, take the night off. Go to the movies. So they did, and they went to see Lovers and Other Strangers. Now, in the movie, there's a wedding scene and a beautiful song that both Richard and Karen flipped for, and of course, he made sure it was waiting for him when he got back to the States. Interesting song fact, The Carpenters version actually helped the movie version win for Best Song of the Year at the Academy Awards. Just as the Carpenters were taking off, the Beatles were about to break up. There was a lot of love and mutual respect for each other. Paul McCartney had this to say about Karen. She had the best female voice in the world, melodic, tuneful, and distinctive. And while Karen and her manager were walking out of a restaurant in California, John Lennon was walking in, and he said, "I just wanted to say that I loved your voice, love." I know, it's terrible. I try. She said, "Did he really mean that?" Because she was incredibly humble. And her manager said, "Of course he meant it. He's John Lennon." Well, now, Ticket to Ride, of course, was originally written by the Beatles as an up-tempo song. Richard thought it would make a great ballad to showcase Karen's voice. Thank you. little bit of Santa and a little bit of jingle. All right, you help me? Okay.
Thank you. Understand the reason why we carry on this way. got in the way. We're lost inside this lonely viewing bay.
Thoughts are leaving, disappearing each time I see those eyes.
Best band here, Mr. Jeff Giano.
sublime as Tiffany DeLay.
This one has some special meaning to me. You see, back home, I have the distinct honor and privilege to take my beautiful golden retriever, whose name is Cash, and we do pet therapy. And we go into the area hospitals, children's hospitals, oncology centers, crisis situations, quite honestly, wherever we're needed. And he's magic at the end of a leash. And just by touching his beautiful fur, there's a change in a child or a change in a parent or whatever anybody is going through at that particularly difficult time. And I've learned a lot by being at the end of that leash and watching these difficult situations and how these families persevere in their courage. And it gives me strength for sure. On the screens here, you'll see some wonderful pictures of just some kids and some animals, and there are some actual working shots of Cash in the hospital. And I dedicate this song to all of them.
The children.
In 1946, an 18-year-old young man named Frank Pooler was stationed overseas, and it was the holiday time, and he missed his fiancée very, very much. So he wrote her a poem, and from what I understand, they never stayed together. He ended up marrying somebody else, but he kept that poem. Now, fast forward 20 years, that same Frank Pooler is now Richard and Karen's choir director at Cal State Long Beach. So he has the poem and he gives it to Richard and he says, do you think you could put some music to it? Well, from what I've learned, 15 minutes later, one of the most beloved Carpenters holiday songs was born. And with this song, we wish everybody the happiest and healthiest holiday, whatever it is that you celebrate, and a healthy new year.
Greeting cards have all been sent. The Christmas rushes through. I still have one wish to make. A special one for you.
Us up here when we have the enthusiasm out here, so we thank you. Of course, we want to thank the Palace Theater for having us, and once again, Eric on sound, you are heaven sent, and we really, really appreciate, because up here it sounds great. I don't even know what it sounds like out there, but up here, it's beautiful up here, so we thank you. And of course, We would certainly be remiss if we didn't thank the most important people of all, Richard and Karen Carpenter, for this music. It is a joy to perform it. And make sure that if you have young people in your family, play the music for them. Make it stay relevant. That's what we're trying to do. What we're our journey is bringing all of this music live to people so that they can hear it again. But even if you can't sing well, I don't care. Just lip sync to the music in your house. Just make sure that those young ones are listening to it. It doesn't matter. Okay? Promise? All right. So once again, you know that Facebook thing. You know, I'm going to do a post later, and there'll be some stuff for sale out there. It's no pressure, but it'll be out there. We're going to come out. Polly and I are going to come out. We're going to say hi to everybody. So we'll leave you with this one. I'll say goodbye, love. No one ever cared if I should leave or die. Time and time again, a chance for love has passed me by. And all I know of love is how to live without it. I just can't seem to find it. So made my mind up, I must live my life. Though it's not the easy way, I guess I've always known I'd say goodbye to love. There are no tomorrows for this heart of mine. Surely time heals these bitter memories, and I find that there is someone to believe in and to live for. Something I could live for. promise you're going to help. All right. I know you know this one. You know it, right?
Top of the world.